Does a new actress breathe life into a newer Hollywood favorite? Hi, I'm Seth. Welcome to Video Picks. I review a movie and give you other movie titles that are in the same genre. Great to have you here. Today we're reviewing The Girl in the Spider's Web. The Girl in the Spider's Web stars Claire Foy from The Crown as Elizabeth Salander, Sylvia Hoeks from Blade Runner 2049 as Camille Salander, Regis Stanfield as Edwin Needham, and Stephen Merchant as Franz Butler. The Girl in the Spider's Web is directed by Fede Alvarez. The plot is Hagar Elizabeth Salander and journalist Michael Bloomquist find themselves caught in a web of spies, cybercriminals, and corrupt government officials. This is what is called a soft reboot of the series, as it has a different lead actor. Claire Foy is Elizabeth instead of Rooney Mara, and Stephen Merchant is Michael Bloomquist instead of Daniel Craig. It's supposed to still be in the same universe. The problem with this recasting is that it forces you to make comparison between Claire Foy and Rooney Mara. And some reviewers think Claire Foy's portrayal is a bit disconnected and robotic. But I think that it's just Foy getting into character. In all fairness, how many Bonds have we gone through in 50 years? 6. And yet we still believe that they are the same person, or at least the same numerical designation. To be fair, Elizabeth Salander has always been a hard character to play, as she doesn't emote like the average character. In the Rooney Mara film, she came across as someone who's on the artistic spectrum. And I'm not dragging people who are on that part of the spectrum, because they are in good company. Some of my smartest friends have a hard time connecting with other people because they don't get the subtle conversational cues that the rest of us recognize. The Girl in the Spider's Web, Elizabeth's backstory is a little more revealed, and we get to see how this woman takes. She's unapologetic. She goes after what she wants. She rescues people in need, and then she steals for the greater good. While some people think that Elizabeth Salander has fallen victim to the Me Too movement, I don't think she has. Elizabeth also does a fair amount of hacking and a little bit of stealing because deep in her heart, she wants to protect innocent people from the wolves outside the door. In my mind, there are two different types of characters in action movies. One is like Arnold and one is like the original Rocky. Arnold's character is about brute strength because as a Terminator, he walks right through walls. The other is Rocky, the character that sliced the long road for himself. Rocky was a down-and-out bum who seemed like a lost cause, but he had heart, and he never gave up. Claire Foy is a Rocky character. She's a physically smaller woman, standing at 5'4", and slightly built, she doesn't seem like an action hero. But at Elizabeth Salander, she's all heart. She will not quit. She is a force of nature. She cannot quit until evil has been vanquished. I like this film. I have waited for it to come out since the summer. If you do too, here's some video pics. Colombian artist stars Zoe Saldana and Michael Barton. It's about a young girl who witnesses her parents' murder as a child and grows up to be an assassin and avenge their deaths. Point of No Return stars Bridget Fonda. It's about a criminal who's given a new lease on life as what? An assassin. And my ultimate pick is the original Girl with the Dragon Tattoo, starring Michael Nyquist and Naomi Rapace. Even though this one is dubbed into English from Swedish, it has something that's not in the American films. If you like this video, click like, subscribe, visit my comments and section below, and I really want to thank you for being here today and watching my video. It means a lot to me, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.